Hello students, let's study a poem today. This is chapter 1 from the 8th standard textbook Honeydew. Name of this poem is The Ant and the Cricket. It is a fable. Fable means a story, often with animals as characters that convey a moral. So, fable is a story, often with animals that convey a moral. This is called fable. So this poem is a traditional story that teaches us a moral lessons, and usually the characters in this poem, in this fable, are animals. So this poem also teaches us a very important moral lessons of being industrious like an ant. So industrious means diligent and hardworking. It also teaches us we should not be like the cricket. This poem is about a cricket. Cricket means an insect who found himself in trouble as the winter season arrived. So he found that he had nothing to eat, nor had he cared to make a shelter for himself. He decided to go to an ant for help. He wished to borrow some grain from her and to spend a day or two in her hole during the rainy days. So the cricket decided to meet the ant for some help, to buy some grain or something for the rainy days. His intention was to pay her back later on. However, the ant did not help the cricket. She told him without mincing words that it was rule of ants that they neither borrowed nor lent. She asked the cricket in astonishment if he had not saved anything for the winter, to which the cricket replied negatively. She asked him the reason. So the ant asked to the cricket, what is the reason? He replied, he was so busy enjoying his life. He did not bother to save or put by anything. The ant taught him to go and dance during the winter also. In conclusion, we can be said that we must be responsible for our future. We must not just spend our good times idly. We must also secure our future against the bad time also. So friends, this was the brief summary of the lesson, The Ant and the Cricket. So this poem tells us the story of a careless cricket, a careless insect who was busy in singing only and never thought and did anything for his future, and an ant who was very sincere to his work and taught and did for the future. So the ant lived with self-respect even in harsh time, while the cricket had to beg and could not survive harsh hour of winter. Through the poem, the lesson what has been delivered to the mankind is that we should lead happy moments, but not by ignoring our future. Careful planning is essential for everyone, and it ensures a secure future. You know friends, the moral of this poem is that we should work harder for our own sake and for the time of troubles. Moreover, always remember that today's saving is tomorrow's income. So this was the poem The Ant and the Cricket. We studied about a brief summary of this poem, and now let's study some new words and its meaning, and also some important questions and answers from this lesson. So let's start. New words from the lesson. Accustom to, which means addicted to or in habit of. An example is, he is accustomed to sit idle. Next word is a crumb. Crumb means a piece. And the example is, the dog grabbed a crumb of bread. Next is starvation, which means hunger. And the example is, starvation made him very weak. Gay, which means happy. Children are gay on Sundays. Shelter, home. Our basic needs are food, clothing and shelter. Questions and answers from the lesson. Question number 1. The cricket says, oh, what will become of me? When does he say it and why? Answer. The cricket said the given line when it found that its cupboard was empty and winter had arrived. It could not find a single crumb to eat on the snow-covered ground and there were no flowers or leaves on the tree. It wondered that what would become of it because it was getting cold and since there was nothing to eat, it would starve and die. Question number 2. The ant tells the cricket to dance the winter away. Do you think the word dance is appropriate here? If so, why? And the answer is, the ant told the cricket to dance the winter away because when it asked the cricket what it did in the summer and why it had not stored any food for summers, the cricket answered that it sang through the warm and sunny months of summers. Therefore, in reply to this, the ant asked the cricket to dance the winter away just like it sang all through the summers and did not bother to store food for winters. Question number 3. Which lines in the poem express the poet's comment? Read them loud. Write the comment in your own words. And the answer is, the lines in the poem that express the poet's comment are, folks call this a fable. I will warrant it true. This comment by the poet means that this poem is indeed a fable as it had a moral behind it. The cricket did not have anything to eat during the winters because it did not bother to store some food during summers. It was negligent and sang all through the summers. The ant, on the other hand, had built a nice home for itself and had stored food so that it would not starve during winters. It worked hard during summers to achieve this. Thus, the moral of the poem is to be prepared for the adverse time and always work hard instead of being negligent. According to you, what is more essential for survival? Having the sense of reality or being in imaginary world? Justify your answer with reference of the poem The Ant and the Cricket. And the answer is, according to me, the most essential thing for survival is the sense of reality and not being in the imaginary world. This has been proven by the due context of the poem, The Ant and the Cricket. At first, in the poem, we get to know about the young cricket who is very much interested in making merry in the pleasant weather of summer. He is not at all inclined toward the storage of provision for the future. And this unplanned approach made him face the misfortune of starvation and famine in the rough winter season. But on the other hand, the ant, which is mostly considered as miser because of his preservation attitude, making it capable of fighting against starvation and famine in the rough time of winter. Its planning regarding future provisions proves to be the actual sense of reality, what helps it to win the struggle for survival. Because of this, to me, the sense of reality is more essential for survival than that of being in the imaginary world. Question number 5. What did the ant ask the cricket? And the answer of this question is, without having anything preserved in the cupboard, the cricket willingly had come to the miser ant in the hope of borrowing some food and shelter. The ant then asked the cricket that what he was doing in summer times. Question number 6. What was the ant's suggestion to the cricket? Answer. In reply of the ant's question that what the cricket was doing in summer times, the cricket told that he had sung in the beautiful and charming weather of summer. So the ant suggested the cricket now to indulge in dancing in the rough season of winter. So today we studied a new lesson, a poem, The Ant and the Cricket. It's a short poem, it's an interesting poem. So I hope you understood this poem very clearly, and also we studied some new words and its meaning also, and some important question answers. So we'll meet you in next video with another important chapter. Till then, goodbye.